mention shoppers. Oh. We're having a sale today.
Hey, what is up, everyone? Hello, it's me, Josh Akujo. I'm back after who knows how long has it been. It's been actually 3 months now. More than 3 months. I think the last time that I streamed was in September. And I was on a little break. I'm back. I'm re-debuting. Hello. Hello, hello, everyone. Jinx, Zara, Honey, welcome to the stream. Thank you for the resub and the singular bit. Oh my goodness, I'm incredibly nervous at the moment. Okay, so as you can tell by the title, that I am indeed re-debuting today. I'm here to show off, I reintroduce myself, show off this newly rigged model, as you might be able to see here. You see, I'm able to move much better now. I'm much more expressive, hopefully. Yes, yes, very, very expressive. Chaos reigns, and we have the first battle royale of the stream. Everyone, good luck, good luck. Okay. So let me just preface this. Of course, hello, my name is Josh Akujo. I'm your local grocery store VTuber. It's very nice to meet you if you've never met me before. If you do know me, hi, I'm back. Okay, so first things first, the reason that I was on break for those 3 months was because my brother, that makes it sound like I'm blaming him, but no, my brother was in another state doing an assignment for his job for a couple months, and then he came back home, stayed here for a couple months while he was looking for a new apartment for him and his my sister-in-law. So they were here, we were sharing rooms for the past 3 months, and there wasn't any time for me to be streaming at that time. So that's why I wasn't able, you haven't seen me live in quite a long time. I'm pretty sure the last thing that I streamed was Splatoon 3, it was during a Splatfest. I'm pretty sure it was the last day of the Splatfest that I streamed. Redebuting from a grocery store clerk to an unemployed... No, I'm still employed! I'm still very much employed, still very much full-time worker. Which is also what I've just been doing all this time since I haven't been streaming. It's just that I've been working. There's really not that much, new. I've been doing the same old, just working hard. Things have gotten a bit more, busy with the new year at my workplace, so, that's keeping me quite busy. But I've made time to, be here with everyone again, because I wanted to be live. I wanted to come back to streaming. Because it's a very nice hobby for me to find something to do in between working. Because if I wasn't doing something like this, I'd probably go insane, especially if I wasn't playing video games, which is another thing that I've just been doing all this time. Okay, I see that. Okay, so someone has redeemed bald model. It's actually not a model in and of itself anymore, rather it's a toggle now. So, and I'll just go ahead and do it. So this is how I look like bald with this newly rigged model now, and you can all say it now. Let's go. Bald my eyes. Okay, of course, I wasn't just going to do this, you know, just talking section. I did want to. I prepared yet another PowerPoint slide, much like the first time I debuted in 2021 when I was still on YouTube. I made another PowerPoint presentation because I don't have any other way to make a presentation. I was thinking Prezi, but then I remembered that you need to pay for that. I thought it was free. I thought it was free, but it might have been free because the last time I used it, I was a student. Google Slides, the throat goat. Oh, shoot. I didn't even think about Google Slides. Oh, well. It's all done. I can't import everything this fast. Oh, damn. He's really bald. I am really bald, Evelio. Is that how you say your name? Evelio? Also, welcome to the stream. You should have a redeem so that we can submit wigs to you. A wig, huh? A wig would mean that I would have to make some assets for that. That's a thought for another time. But I am going to go ahead and, by the way, is the volume okay? Is my voice volume, the background music volume good? You might have noticed, by the way, that some of the emotes are just floating on the stream, but also some of them are just falling on me. Lower the music a tick. I can do that. I can do that. I can fix that. Which one am I doing? This one? Yeah, like that. Yeah, they're falling down now. I'm gonna take off the bald for now. I'll go back to bald, but I wanted this to be a bit proper. I wanted to properly reintroduce myself. So I am going to go into my PowerPoint presentation. Oh, shoot. Wait, I spoiled it. Well, I mean, it's not really spoiled. That's literally the second page, isn't it? Okay, wait. Where's the presentation? There it is. I knew that. Okay. I forgot to reset to the first page. And by the way, I made the mistake the first time I debuted by using a old version of the PowerPoint that I had made because I somehow forgot to press save that time, but I made sure this time that I did press save often. So, no repeating that mistake again. Here's the beginning slide. Joshua Cujo, person ordinaire to Electric Boogaloo, as this is my re-debut. I may have repurposed my old PowerPoint presentation when I did this, although I did give it a new background, which is the same background that I have for my reference sheet now, which is something that I made. Also, this logo is something that I made myself, actually. I made the design of it. The lettering actually came from a website that was just that I just used for 3D lettering. I forgot what it was called, but that's it. But the design itself, like the background, that was me. I spent like a afternoon making that. Okay, let's go into the first one. Yeah. Okay. That's me. It's me. I'm Joshua Cujo. Hi. Nice to meet ya. As you can see right there, that's my full body model. The model that I'm using right now is still half body, meaning I have no legs. I have no hands either. That'll be for another time. But I did end up drawing my full body model at some point. So that's there now. The pants are looking a bit shiny, of course. The shoes are lackluster. Don't worry about the fact that the shoes may have been the last and most rushed part. No toes, I'm out. The toes are going to be a tier 3 sub redeem once I actually get legs. So you just wait for that. You just wait for that. You don't get the Cujo's for free. So Cujo. No, that's me. What am I doing? I don't know if you could tell that I didn't practice anything or plan anything out for all of this. But I am 25 years old. I actually turned 25 last month, December 16th. Yes, it was my birthday that day. Majestic Jasmine, welcome to the stream. Thanks for stopping by. I'm 25 now by VTuber standards. I am indeed an old man now. And I remember when the Twitter space was only networking posts. No. No. It's okay. It was actually a good time, my birthday. I was actually... Oh, here's the thing. Here's a little story. I was actually on a weight loss competition all throughout those 3 months that I was gone as well. And I was... The competition ended on the 30th of December, and I am pretty sure that I won. I think they're gonna officially announce the winner next week, but I am pretty sure I won. Now, during those 3 months that I was trying to lose weight, I was on a diet. I was on a keto diet, and I did not eat a lot of carbs throughout that whole time. I didn't eat any rice. I didn't eat any bread. I cheated 3 times. One was on Thanksgiving, and then it was 2 days, my birthday and the day after my birthday. Because on my birthday, I went to Outback Steakhouse with my parents, and then the day after, I went to go get sushi with my brother. Those are some good eats. To be fair, we met on a networking post over a year ago, so I'm thankful for them. Oh yeah, I've met so many people. You, including Honey as well, others that I met on those networking posts. Those were some... I look fondly on those. On those early days. When everyone was still trying to figure out who they were gonna be. It was whimsical in a way. Anyway, I'm still waiting on that result for the competition, because I really want that $2,000 prize money. Yeah. I want that prize money, because I'm going to... I want to get my family some gifts, and then get myself something. I don't know what I'm going to buy for me. I'm going to get some presents for my family, and then I'm going to get something for me. Yeah. Okay. So next... I am 5'9". Last time that my initial debut, I was 5'8". I went to a doctor's appointment last year, found out I grew an inch. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Josh, buying some legs. Oh, you want me to buy legs with my money? And some toes. I'll think about it. I'll have to think about it. See if the rigor is available. I think she's currently has her commissions closed, but another time. I am a grocery store employee, as you probably know. It's how I present myself. I work in a grocery store. It's very cruel work. It can be cruel work. Sometimes it's okay, but you know how people are. You know how people are. As for nicknames, you can call me Josh or Jojo. That's what most people call me, Josh or Jojo. There's really not much else. I don't think anyone really calls me just Joe. I don't think anyone really calls me Cujo. So it's usually just Joshua, Josh, or Jojo. You can use anyone. If you have anything creative, you can use that as well. Yeah, you do call me baby girl, so that, you know what? That's fine. That's fine as well. I debuted on May 12, 2021. Back then, I was actually streaming on YouTube. I was on YouTube, and here's a fun fact about that. My debut was the first time I ever streamed. And you could tell, because the debut is still on my YouTube page. It's the first video I ever uploaded. And you can clearly tell that it was the first time I ever streamed. There was... like, you can hear the way I sound right now, the way my mic sounds. I was using a Blue Yeti back then, and I didn't have any, a compression or gates. EQ and all that. No gain in my mic. and it sounded horrible. It sounded absolutely horrible. But thankfully, like hopefully I sound well now. And who knows, maybe I'll think of another way to make myself sound a bit better. If there is a way. Frozen, welcome to the stream. Thanks for stopping by. Sorry I'm late to the party. No problem, man. Your presence here is enough. As you can see on the bottom, there's a silhouette of a little blobby thing. You'll see him later. You've probably already seen him if you've seen my Twitter. If you just follow me, my Twitter, see what I've been up to, you'll find that little silhouette, but you'll see him later as well. Next page. Also, this art is made by VTuber OG. OG. OG OG. I love their artwork. The moment their commissions were open, I was like swooped in. Cause I always wanted to commission them. And I finally did. And that's me. That's me. That's doing the pogi pose. Something prevalent in Filipino culture. Just means, you know, it's handsome. I'm handsome, right? You see that? A5 Wagyu of a man? A5 Wagyu? That's me. This is my lore, quote-unquote lore. a four-panel comic that I may or may not have made within the span of 5 minutes. Just because I thought it would be funny. It was just...
It was a normal day. We're Joshua Cujo at Cujo's Groceries. And then it wasn't.
You know, I always thought my lore would be like a light novel, like a slice of life light novel. But then I thought about it more and I felt like it would fit if my lore was more a four comic gag manga. And that's pretty much what it is. Four comic gag manga. There you go. Jojo, you broser and you grosser. Hey, what is up, Huffy? Welcome to the stream. Thank you for stopping by. You are here on my re-debut. Thank you, thank you. I was just explaining my lore, quote unquote lore, and it's pretty much just me doing my everyday beep, beep. Scanning, doing all that scanning. Next customer, what do I see? Extra species, beings. They just showed up in my grocery store one day, and they've just been there ever since. Maybe they were always there, and I just took notice of them now. But that's pretty much how it is, isn't it? That's how. When you really think about how VTubers collab, the difference in models and concepts. It's a little like that. Next slide! So these are my likes, my hobbies, my dislikes. I am a basic... Wait, let me do this again. A basic of a person. I really hope that worked. You know, I like what most people would like. I like eating, I like singing songs. I like, just the basics of life, that's pretty much it. I love staying in all day. I am as introverted as you would expect. It's like, if there were any opportunity to never leave my bed, to not have to go to work, I would take that opportunity always. yeah. I also have a very bad hobbit. Whoa, hobbit. No, we're not talking about... Tolkien. I have a very, very bad habit of getting sucked into cooking videos on YouTube. It's like I start one cooking video, I will never stop. Of course, I watch stuff like Binging with Babish and all that. Recently, I got into these two guys that do cooking, like short cooking videos. One of them, I forget their names. I know one of them is called Albert Can Cook. He does some comedic short cooking videos that I enjoy quite a lot. they're funny too. And then there's this one other guy. He makes short videos. He always starts the videos with something like, "Hey babe, what would you like for lunch?" And then his wife will say a food and he would just make that food. And I get sucked into those kinds of videos very easily. And it's like, there goes my whole afternoon. Also, Neat NF, welcome to the stream. Thanks for stopping by. My hobbies include singing. If you follow me, you know that I post quite a lot of song covers. Short song covers, usually up to the first chorus. That's how I post my covers. But I like singing. I would say that I'm a decent singer. I wouldn't say that I'm like really good, but I'd say I'm like a solid 7, a solid like 7 or a 6.9 nice of a singer. Like, I could do better. Thing is, I'm not musically trained. I've always wanted to be. I always wanted to do a instrument, like learn an instrument, but I tried. I tried when I was younger. I wanted to take like music class. For some reason it didn't work out, or maybe I just wasn't put into it. So I never learned like that, and I would have trouble learning by myself. So, which is very strange considering my next hobby, which is collecting small instruments. You might see on that top picture, those are the instruments that I have that I could find in my house. So you might see 3 flutes, I think. Okay, 2 of them are Shinobue's. Neat NF, thank you for the follow. Welcome to the stream. Oh, I already said welcome to the stream, but thank you for the follow. And then the one in the middle is a Chinese... I don't know how to say it. I think it's called a Dizi? D-I-Z-I. I don't know how to pronounce that. But it's a flute as well. So I have 3 flutes. I have the thing that looks like a piano. That's called a melodica. Which is one of the ones where you, it has a, like a plastic tube that you blow into, and then it'll make a noise only when you blow into it, and then it plays like a piano. The one to the right of that, that is a kalimba, which is kind of like a hand piano. It makes a very soothing, like a soothing sound. You pronounced it pretty close. I think I know what you're trying to do there. I'm not gonna fall into it. Also, wish you welcome to the stream. Thanks for stopping by. If that is what I think that you're trying to do, I ain't gonna do it. Is it? You mean it actually? Because I think I tried it as... I thought it was pronounced Dizi. Like Dizi. D-I-Z-I Dizi? I don't know, like that. And of course I have these 2, as you can see right there, kazoos. I always have a kazoo on my desk, because who knows when I'll need it. Multi-purpose tool kazoos. It's technically the only instrument that I know how to play, because all you need to do is hum into it. I also have an automaton that I couldn't find, and I'm pretty sure that thing didn't have any batteries left. And I also had a harmonica, which I also can't find. I don't know where they are, but I'm pretty sure they're in my house somewhere. Yeah, and again, I collect those small instruments. I don't know how to play them. I'm not musically trained. I wouldn't be able to play you anything if you asked me to on the kalimba, melodica, the flutes. I could play you something on the kazoo, though. That's even one of the redeems. I can do something on the kazoo. Because it's easy. It's easy. Cooking is another hobby of mine. I mostly actually... Would I call it a hobby? Kind of. I learned how to cook because right after high school is when I first lost weight, and that's when I learned how to cook, from following a diet. As you could see in the pictures, first of all, the one underneath the kalimba, those are just all the cookbooks that I own. Mostly keto cookbooks. I have two Binging with Babish books for some reason. Filipino cookbooks. The Food Lab by J. Kenji Lopez Alt. I think it's another Asian cookbook as well as a Japanese cookbook. Japanese home cooking cookbook. So those are the cookbooks that I have in my bookshelf right behind me. Although, of course, you can't see it. But they're there. And then those four pictures surrounding the cookbooks, those are some of the things that I have cooked. The I'm going to say this wrong. Succubishi. Please tell me I said that right. Because I know it's like succubi. It's not succubaishi, is it? Succubishi? But welcome to the stream. Thank you for stopping by. And I'm very sorry if I say your name wrong. I'm sorry if I say anyone's name wrong. It's a very bad way of disrespecting people. So if I say your name wrong, I do apologize. The second one. Okay, so it's succubaishi. So it is following the name succubi. Okay. I will remember that. Hey, Zeb, welcome to the stream. Thank you for stopping by. There he is. There's my favorite anime for tag. Yes, your favorite Yonkoma, four panel comic gag manga protagonist. That's me. You can call me Lola. Okay. I always try to remember like all these nicknames. I try to write them down. There was a list that I had full of nicknames for guests that would come by.
As always, thank you for showing.
Oh, hey, Jen Diced. Please tell me that I said that wrong. Jen Diced, welcome to the stream. Thank you for stopping by. Where was I? Oh yeah, I was talking about the food surrounding the cookbooks. Those are things that I've made. Just some of the things that I made. The first one being a beef soup. That beef soup that I made was absolutely amazing. I forgot what it was made. It was, I think, chuck roast, and I think also beef short ribs. Oh man, that was so good. I made like a whole bunch of it, and put the rest in the freezer, so that I would just be able to eat it throughout the week. Because that's what I did for the weight loss competition. I made food in bulk, and then froze them so that I would just eat it throughout the week. That's how I got through it. That's how I win. That's how I win. Hopefully won. The second picture is not necessarily impressive cooking-wise, because they are just grilled cheese. They're grilled cheese and tomato bisque. And the thing about grilled cheese and tomato bisque is that every now and then, I don't plan it. Well, I guess I plan it the day before I do it, the day before I decide to do it. But every now and then, I just have a day or evening where all I'm doing is making grilled cheese and eating it with tomato bisque. That day that I made those grilled cheese, I bought 10 types of cheeses so that I could do a whole bunch of what's it called? Combinations. That was very delicious. And then I regretted it the next day because that did, it messed up my stomach. It messed up my stomach bad. Cooking stream when? I gotta find a way to do it. If you want that, I would have to find a way to, maybe I'll have one of those, cameras. It's like a helmet, you just wear on your head, then it'll be the camera just like jutting out from the top of it, so all you'll see is the top down. It's kind of like how actually Kenji Lopez Alt does his cooking videos. He has it like on a rig, just like he's wearing it on his head, something like that. I've seen other creative ways to do it. There's a VTuber called Onigiri that does cooking streams. The way they do it, it's pretty cool. It's like they have their hands, like their actual hands, protruding out. And you could see it. That's cool. The one below the grilled cheese, that was a beef hash. It was a recipe that I got. I tried Blue Apron because I was... Do not sponsor me, Blue Apron. I don't care about you. but I tried Blue Apron once, and that was one of the recipes that I got for it. It was a beef hash. It did taste good, though. It did taste good, but Blue Apron, you do not need to sponsor me. I don't care. And then the one next to that is a pizza. It's not... The crust is not bread, per se. The crust is actually made out of mozzarella cheese. It's like a whole bunch of mozzarella cheese mixed with butter and cream cheese. You microwave those for a couple of minutes until everything is, you know, like melted. Then you, once you're done microwaving it, you stir it all together, make the mix, and then you add almond flour and an egg or two. I think I only used one egg. But you mix that all together, that becomes like a faux bread. And then that's what I used for the crust for the pizzas. Because, you know, even if I was on a diet and my diet was restricted, I was not going to have a pizza. Too bad I couldn't have pineapples, because pineapple pizza is pretty good. You could fight me on that. I won't hear any arguments that pineapple pizza is bad, because pineapple pizza is pretty good. You cannot convince me otherwise. Okay, that's about my hobbies. Pineapple stays on the pizza. Exactly. Pineapple stays on the pizza, and thank you for starting a battle royale. Everyone, good luck. May the bloodshed be swift and true. May you arrive victorious. My dislikes, so I am deathly afraid of driving. I learned how to drive, but I can't say I'm good at driving, and I can't say that I enjoy driving a lot. like, to this day, I don't frequent the highway all that much, and driving to new areas just, like, fills me with fear. Pretty much anywhere that, is full of cars, I tend to freeze up, which is why I never go north of where I live. North of where I live, the roads are horrible, so I never go there, because I never want to drive in that area. Pineapple on pizza, damn, I thought you were a keeper. Oh no, I lost you. I lost you. I had you for a moment, then I lost you. Ah, dang it. Dang it. No, but you can't change my mind, though. Sorry, Lola. I still like pineapple on pizza. Evelio, congratulations on winning the Battle Royale. Enjoy your 300 gold. I don't think gold really has any value here. But it's nice to have a big number. Being out of my bed, because, man. Again, if there was any moment, any opportunity for me to just stay in bed, maybe I'll have a laptop in bed too. Or just, you know, just... Not even in my bed, just be in my room. Being out of my room. I'm a shut-in by heart. If there was any opportunity to just stay a shut-in, I would stay a shut-in. But no, I need a job and I need money, so I work. But on my days off, most of the time I am in my room. Playing video games, surfing the internet, watching cooking videos, that's how I do it. Cleaning dishes. Like, who the hell wants to clean dishes? It's the worst part. There's always the meme. Cooking is 5 hours cooking plus prepping, 10 minutes eating, 10 hours cleaning. Something to that effect. I hate cleaning dishes. That's pretty much it for my likes and dislikes. I mean, there are things, but there are more things, but they don't always need to be said. If they pop up, I'll say them. Also, if you have any questions, feel free to ask them. I'll try to, what's it called? Answer them as best as I can. The never-ending tortures, laundry, dishes, and taxes, exactly. Which is why when I grow up, well, I guess I'm already grown up. Technically, I am grown up, but if I ever have my own house and I have a dishwasher, I will use that dishwasher and not use it as a storage, as so many of my culture do. I will not use it as storage. I will use it as a dishwasher. Okay, so now we're getting into games. I, of course, am a god gamer. Not really. I tend to play a lot of single-player games. And it's not because I don't have people to play with. I just like playing... single-player games. No small number of Nintendo franchises. I think the last time I had my debut, I just listed a bunch of games and franchises. Most of them were Nintendo. I didn't want to take up all that space, so I'll just say... a lot of Nintendo franchises. Zelda is my favorite franchise of all time. And I can't wait for Tears of the Kingdom that's coming out in March. Now, let's hope it doesn't get delayed. And hopefully it's as good as Breath of the Wild. No, Jojo, that's not the Asian way. Too bad. The cycle ends here. The dishwasher is being used. Persona 5, I played a whole bunch of times. I bought it... the regular game. I bought Royal... I bought Strikers for both the Switch and the PC, and then I just recently bought Persona 5 for the Switch as well. Persona 5 Royal for the Switch. So, at some point I'll probably actually... Yeah, I'll stream that one. That's fine. Metal Gear 3, specifically Metal Gear 3. I like the Metal Gear series, but 3 is my favorite. I first... experienced it watching my big brother play it, and then I took the time to play it myself when I was older. I actually played the 3DS version. No, I played the PS2 version first, and then I played the 3DS version. Yeah, that's right. Okay. BioShock Infinite was actually the first FPS that I ever played. Back then I was a huge not fan of FPSs, but I warmed up to it. I played BioShock Infinite. That was the first one I played, and I enjoyed it a lot. It's funny, I played Infinite before I actually played 1 and 2. I played Infinite first. I didn't understand, like, the small little references scattered throughout that game, but I still enjoyed it. BioShock Infinite is real good. Yeah. Monster Hunter is one of those games. I'm not like crazy about it, but anytime I get into a Monster Hunter game, I tend to never leave. Like I'm playing Monster Hunter for the whole day or for a whole week straight. It's like the moment I start, it's hard for me to stop. That's how addicting Monster Hunter is. the games I plan on streaming, currently before I went on break, I was playing a few games. I was playing like Zelda. No, I was playing... I played Wind Waker prior. Oh, that's gaming. Welcome. Okay, wait, no, that's a... that's a bot, isn't it? Yep, that's a bot. Uh-oh, we got a bot here. Promotion? I don't need promotion. What do you think I am? Bad. No bots here. Was that an that was a bot, wasn't it? I'm not crazy, am I? That was a bot. Anyway. Where was I? Oh yeah, I was playing Wind Waker. I finished that and then right before I went on break, I was playing Twilight Princess, so I will continue playing that. And then after I'm finished with that, I do have Skyward Sword as well, so I'm playing that as well. And then I think I have Link's Awakening for the Switch, so I'll play that. And then once Tears of the Kingdom comes out, once Tears Once Tears of the Kingdom comes out, I will be playing that as well. As for other games that I was playing Splatoon, what else? House Flipper, and this game called The Outer Worlds. Outer Worlds? Yeah, Outer Worlds. I'm probably not continuing Outer Worlds. I don't think it was that interesting. Maybe I will, but we'll see. I was also playing Hades. To anyone who was watching me play Hades and expecting me to keep playing it, I do apologize, but I did finish the game during my break. I was just playing it one day. I was planning on just doing, you know, like farming materials, going through the dungeons, farming materials, and then I ended up beating the game. So I do apologize if you were expecting to watch me play that game. I beat it. It was good. It was a real good game. I was playing it, like, on my... I was playing it in the parking lot of my work right before I, like, clocked in. That's how much I was playing that game. And then I beat it. Very, very addicting game. I like that. They have Hades 2 coming out. Well, there you go. Once Hades 2 comes out, I'll play that. As apologies for finishing the first game off stream. The Yakuza series. I think I own all the Yakuza series that was released on Steam. So I actually wanted to try and stream that. I've already played Yakuza 0. I played Yakuza 0 already. And then I think I started Kiwami 1. But I don't think I ever finished it. So I might try to play that. Ace Attorney is a game that... Oh, wait. What happened to my eyes? Give me 1 second. There you go. Whoops. You saw the glasses already. I planned on showing you that later. But Ace Attorney was a game that I played while I was still streaming on YouTube. And then that was around the first time. For some reason during the summer, my internet tends to crap out. And that was the first time that it happened while I was playing Ace Attorney. And so I never finished that on stream. I was playing the first game. I've already played all throughout all the games except for Investigations, but I was still playing the first game. It was like one of those things. It was one of those streams that I used to help me be able to speak more clearly. It's like you could hear it while I was just speaking a while ago that I tend to slur my words and sometimes stutter a lot. So I used Ace Attorney as a way to help me try and speak better, because it is a visual novel kind of game and there was a lot of dialogue that needed to be said. So I used that as a way to practice speaking, and it was doing pretty well, I think. So I'll probably try to get back into that. Oh no, you look so cute with glasses. I'll put my glasses back on in a bit. Don't you worry about that. The Last Campfire is a game that my mod over there, Honey, she gave me a gift card for my birthday for a Nintendo eShop. And so I used that to buy this cute looking game called The Last Campfire. It's an indie game. It looks like a 3D puzzle game. So I'm going to stream that as a thank you to Honey. Of course, thank you, Honey. And I also want to try playing more indie games. Like, it's easy to be playing all the AAA games, everything that's popular. But I do want to try playing more indie games, because I took a chance with a lot of indie games last year. It's like, it was a... I love discovering new games. I played Hollow Knight and Crypt of the Necrodancer, as well as Cadence of Hyrule. I played those when I was sick in the beginning of 2022. I love those games. I took some other... Hades is also technically a indie game. Tunic was also... It's a game that I actually streamed over here. You could check any vaunts that I have, by the way, on my YouTube channel, which you could find up there. And I think also down below, I think there's a link to it. But I discovered a lot of indie games that I quite enjoyed, and I'm open to finding more, as well as AAA games, but I also wanted to try more indie games. So that's what I have planned in terms of games that I wanted to stream. This photo, by the way, is another piece of artwork that was created by OG. Another time where their commissions were open and I swooped in. Swooped in as fast as I could. It's like, please, more art. Next slide. Oh no, what happened? There you go. Anime. Of course I am an anime fan. Actually, that's put into question recently because I actually haven't actively watched a lot of anime for the past year. And it's due to the fact that I'm real busy. Like, I work a full-time job. I work 10-hour days most of the time. So I think a lot of 2022, I didn't watch a lot of anime. But my favorite anime is actually Yu Yu Hakusho. Yu Yu Hakusho is something that I watched when I was living in the Philippines. There were some anime that were playing, that was playing on the TV. A lot of reruns. And one of them was Yu Yu Hakusho, Dragon Ball Z, of course, Volt SV, by the way, is a little funny thing. I just recently found out that there is a Filipino live action Volt S 5s. Did I say Volt SV? Volt S 5 anime. No, it's not an anime. It's a live action that's being made in the Philippines. I looked at a trailer for it and it looked surprisingly good for a show made in the Philippines. It's like, whoa, I didn't know it was that popular, but apparently it is. There were some other anime that I watched. It's like faintly remember, it was around that time where you find out you're actually conscious and alive. That was when I was watching anime. One of them I wanted to say is like this very old anime called Space Captain Harlock. And I just like faintly remember watching that as well. But around when I was 5 years old, I moved to America and I had a cousin there that, thinking back on it now, they were a huge weeb. They were a huge weeb. And he introduced me to more anime. One of them being Slayers. Slayers, by the way, has an awesome opening. You should totally listen to it. It's called... Oh no, did I forget? No, it's called Get Along. I forgot the singer, but it's called Get Along. He also showed me Baki the Grappler and Inuyasha, which... in hindsight, we're a lot more violent than you should have showed a five-year-old, but I did watch those. And then around the time that I was that I started living in America, I took to watching more anime, usually what was on TV. Of course, on Saturdays, there were 4Kids. If you know 4Kids, there was a lot of anime showing there, whether it was One Piece, Shaman King, the Kirby animated, the Kirby anime. Did I already say Ultimate Muscle? Ultimate Muscle. Shaman King, One Piece, Yu-Gi-Oh! Other things, Sonic? Yeah, Sonic X was an anime showing on 4Kids. There was also Toonami, that was on Cartoon Network at night, that showed like Naruto and Bleach. Cowboy Bebop as well? I don't think I was up late enough to watch Cowboy Bebop though. But, you know, it was around that time. It was one of those. It's the kind of anime that a lot of people who like anime ended up watching early on. It's like the things that got them into anime, like Naruto and Bleach. I think it was around middle school when I took my first foray into watching, you know, like out of away from the most popular stuff, one of the first animes that I chose to watch myself was called Darker Than Black. And I was hooked into that anime. It was really good. I would actually recommend watching that. Darker Than Black is really good. I watched a disappointing amount of harem anime because I was into that for some reason. But I grew out of that, thank goodness. Fate Stay Night, that was one of the animes that I got into as well. I'm not too familiar with Fates as a whole, you know, like the Fate Grand Order and all that. But I still do enjoy the Fate series. Like Fate Stay Night, I did watch Unlimited Blade Works. I didn't watch Heaven's Feel, the movies. I didn't watch Heaven's Feel, the movies. The World God Only Knows is another anime that I watched, which got me into visual novels for a little bit, which is actually another way that I found out about the Fate Stay Night, because Fate Stay Night is a visual novel. So I was into visual novels for a bit. I don't play visual novels anymore. Probably because I don't know how to legally get them. I mean, no, there is, you know, like visual novels that are on the Switch and all that. I just don't find myself buying them very often because a lot of them are not safe for work. I mean, I wouldn't be playing them at work, but I also don't have a reason to be playing them. Oh, Sword Art Online. yeah, Sword Art Online. By the way, the first anime convention I ever went to, that was around the time that Sword Art Online was popular. So that year, when I went to that anime convention, which is still the only anime convention I ever went to, there was just a lot of Kirito and Asuna cosplayers. They were literally grouped together. They were literally all together. They were doing one of those things where you just take the swords and, you know, that you raise them in the air and you just touch them together. That was how many Kirito cosplayers there were. Heaven's Feel is amazing. Best watch when binged together. I'll have to think about watching them at some point. So yes, after that, I think it was around the time Demon Slayer came out. Demon Slayer was like the last anime that I watched before I kind of like fell out of it for a bit. And I mean, it's not like I wanted to stop watching anime, it's just that I didn't have much time to do it. Actually, a couple days ago, I think it was last Monday, I was actually in my brother's apartment, and me and a friend and my brother, we were watching Chainsaw Man. And that was the first anime I watched a whole season of in quite a long time. In like one day. Chainsaw Man was pretty good. Excuse me, one moment. Sorry, just needed to burp a bit. And Huffy, thank you for the cheesy pickup line. Now, do you have a pickup line available, or did you want me to look one up? Just go ahead and tell me whenever you want. Because whichever one. Jojo, please. You want me to search one up? I can do that. Okay, let me look it up. Cheesy pickup line. I want the most trash. Let's see here. Hey, do you like raisins? How'd you feel about a date? Yeah. No. Disgusting. Absolutely disgusting. That's the kind of stuff that would get me slapped at work. Okay, so this is the part where I do my credits. Because I did want to, you know, credit the people that helped me along the way. This is my first model, just as a reference. This I'm gonna switch into my old model. This is my old model. This is the model that I debuted with. It was rigged by a guy named Alpion58 over at Fiverr. This is what I've been using up until now. I'm still very fond of it, of course, because I used it all throughout my career as a VTuber. But then I figured it was around time. It was time for me to step it up a bit. One of my friends' commissions were still open, and I asked if they were willing to re-rig my model, and thankfully they did. The art, by the way, for this for my model was made by me, actually. I drew it myself. Miraculously, because I'm not that good of an artist, but I was able to make my own model. It's as simple as it gets, but of course, I mean, I made it regardless. Let me go back into my new model here. And let me just switch here. This is the model that you see right now. Captain Doomsday. Cap. Welcome to the stream. Thanks for stopping by. This is the model that I'm using right now. It was rigged by Sunny Hinode, a friend of mine. They were open. And I actually received the model right before I went on break. So I wasn't able to use it up until now. Live, anyway. Nice work, Grocery Daddy. No problem. No problem at all. So this is what I have to work with now. It's a lot more range of motion. See that? I could tilt. I can look. You know, I can look to the sides. I could look down like that. It looks really good. Much wigglier. I love it. Here, let me actually show it to you, yeah? So, like, let me do it this way. Let's see here. Let's go front and center. So, first of all, I actually already made a bunch of, you know, like, alternate clothings. Whether it's Dark Cujo. Oh, no, I still have the Christmas stuff. Don't worry about that. The convenience store outfit, which is, oh, I always forget the name of the store that I modeled the what's it called? Uniform. I want to say it's not Family Mart, is it? It's a Japanese convenience store chain. But I forget which one that I modeled it after. Foot Locker? No, it was not Foot Locker. I'm also not a wrestling referee. Lawson's. Is it Lawson's? It's one of those. I thought it might have been Family Mart, but it could be Lawson's. This just adds suspenders to my outfit. And there we go there. Just a little dashing little suspenders. This I did as a joke. It's just based off the coloring of Wakana Gojo from My Dress Up Darling. It's because our designs are remarkably similar in that we're just regular dudes. And then this is the one I made for whenever I play Splatoon. I also have these. They're just switched up ties. See, look, the tie is different. This is a dino tie. This is a panda tie. Panda wheeling guns. Good thing Jodo's not a ref, to be honest. Those guys about to get whooped. I'm gonna kill him. Jojo-kun. And then last one is a striped tie. I think I made a whole bunch of ties, but these are the ones I like the most. They're all little neat looking. Just a little things to spice things up. The Yoshikage Kira. Oh, that's such a good idea, though. That is such a good idea. I should do that. Thank you. I'm gonna write that down, actually. Yoshikage Kira Tai. I'm gonna do that. I'll do that for you. Yep. Okay. So those are all the alternate costumes that I have. Let me actually show you my toggles. My facial expressions, first off being angry. Just your standard angry emote. The yandere. Ah, I see. You went to Walgreens, didn't you? You went to Safeway, didn't you? No. Oh, yeah. Watch this one. Ready? Let me get a bit closer. Let me get closer. Then I go. Dun 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 dun. Dish. Oh, wait. I actually have something for that. Here, let me do it this way. Ready? I'm gonna do this first, and then I'm going to do this. Hopefully it's not loud enough. I hope it's not too loud. Let me just, okay, good. 3, 2, 1. Oh, I hope that worked. I'm gonna replay that one. I'm gonna have to remember that. I'm gonna have to remember that. Where am I? 1 hour. I'm at 1 hour. Yeah, I have a Vine Boom sound effect. I have a few sound effects that I added into my stream deck. All it needed was a lip bite. I can't do a lip bite, unfortunately. Maybe another time. I'll commission a lip bite emote. Where was I? Hey, I did the rock. Is my little shocked? This a lot of these are also remnants of my old model that carried on into my newly rigged model. There's that. The dot eyes, which is one of my favorite things because it just looks so dopey. It's one of my favorite just facial expressions because it's like zero brain activity whenever you look at it. I like that both you and I love that both you and Honey run those. It's good. It's like, staring into the sun. Staring right straight into the sun. A smug face. Clearly, you don't own an air fryer. I actually don't know where my air fryer is at the moment. It might be outside. I haven't seen that thing in a couple of months. Little blush. Makes me look soft. Make me look at you softly, I mean. This is my normal state of existence. Just being tired. I don't know why I didn't think about having eye bags from the beginning, but when I got my model rigged again, I said, I need eye bags. Please give me eye bags. And Sunny made it possible. Absolutely possible. A little sad face when I watch you leave from the grocery store and walk right into that CVS. Right into my view, because for some reason there's always a CVS right across from another store. Is it a CVS or is it a Walgreens? I don't know. I don't know why I have this one. Wait, let me. No. That's the mind broken look. The look of a man who has nothing left. Just a little smile to show you how happy I am for when I look at you, because you're all such beautiful people. I think that's all the this one as well. A little awkward look away. That's all the expressions I have. Toggles, in terms of toggles, I have the eye bags just by themselves. Then I could toggle on any expression. Bald, of course. Hey, look, I'm bald again. And, of course, glasses. This time they're not assets, like, you know, just static images. They are linked to my model. Look at that, you can even see the reflection moving. See that? See that? It's cool, ain't it? Yes. And that's everything new with this model. And it looks amazing. Again, Sunny, thank you very much for doing this for me. Alright, back to it. Now, you might think that this is all that I have to offer. There is actually something else that I have. And I'm gonna show it to you right now. Hi. Yo. Let me just... There you go. What is up? How you doing? Can I do... Oh, there you go. That's what I meant to do. As you can see... Oh, wait, let me actually turn the page. This is Joshua Gujo. A slime model that, that I had commissioned from Pia. PiaPI. She was the one that, did the art for this model. And then it was rigged by Kurono Gomi. Ain't it cute? All jiggly. Look at that. Move it side to side. Side to side, like a plate of Jell-O. Let me show you some stuff for this guy. Let me go full body. Like this. Yep. Show you what I got for this guy. He's a little angry. A little bit of happiness. With the eyes, it looks so creepy, which is also a toggle, by the way. I can also just make the eyes blank. Be a bit sad. You don't want to make this face sad, do you? Why would you want to do that? Get squished up. For those times where you're just feeling pressured. Got also some mouths. Some different kinds of mouths, like this. See what else? Maybe a little smug little blob. Smug little blob. See that? Oh, and I also have this. And boing. Boing. Nice little bouncing animation right there. Would you look at that? It's cute, ain't it? Pia was offering to offering commissions for slime models. I think I was the first one that applied for it. He do the bounce. You could still see it if I do this. Right? Bounce. Da-da-da-da-da-da. I also received this like right after the 2.0 model. And I wasn't able to showcase that either. But now I finally get to do it. And I get to credit the lovely artist who helped make this happen. These are the, oh, by the way, I have this scanner. I don't know why it didn't show up either, while I was doing all that, but I do have this scanner that's linked to my mouse, and if I click, it does a little that. See, look. Beep. I could also toggle that, so that doesn't show up. So these are my backgrounds, the usual backgrounds that I have, either for streaming or for like the little videos that I upload on Twitter or YouTube. They were, I commissioned these from a team, a guy, well, they're actually a team of background artists on Fiverr. The profile on Fiverr is Sangngg. They're a group called Infinity Freaks. They're a group based in Vietnam. Here's a cool thing about Infinity Freaks that I found out. So I commissioned these guys for my background, and then I asked them, like, what's a good way for me to credit you? So they gave me the Infinity Freaks. This was a while ago. The Infinity Freaks website that they provided is no longer in use, so I had to dig around a bit, and I did find like an account on another platform for these guys, and I was looking through it while I was making this PowerPoint presentation, and I noticed on their the stuff that they've worked on, like kind of like a portfolio, they have a credit for a little movie called Tenki no Ko, also known as Weathering with You, which, if you don't know what that is, it is the movie that came after Kimi no Na wa, or Your Name, by Makoto Shinkai. And I was like, what? These guys worked on that movie? So here's a little bit of context. I own the Weathering with You Blu-ray that I bought sometime around 2022 that I never opened. Oh, excuse me. I'm so sorry about that. So I have the Blu-ray for that I never opened. And then I finally opened it when I found out that these guys worked on that movie. I put it into my PS4 because who the hell owns a Blu-ray player? And I skipped all the way to the end. I still didn't watch the movie. But I skipped all the way to the end towards the credits. And I watched the credits roll past until they got to the part where they list all the background artists. And lo and behold, I see a group of Vietnamese names. The group is based in Vietnam. There's a name, Sangngg Nguyen, which is like, oh wow, that's them, isn't it? And then I look around further for like Infinity Freaks' profile. They have a Facebook page, and in that Facebook page they have a photo, or just like a picture, of the Weathering With You credits showcasing those very same names. And it's like, oh wow, that is them. So that's like a cute little tidbit, a cool little tidbit regarding my background artist. And to this day, I still haven't watched Weathering With You. One day I'll watch it. I own it for some reason. I bought it for some reason. I think I bought it because I like Your Name that much, but I still haven't watched it. What if you get another background, like an office or a store manager? I could. I always wanted to commission more backgrounds, but I never got around to doing it. But I'll have to try it out. Try to do that another time. Maybe with the prize money that I get, that I hope that I get for that competition. Let's watch it? Yeah, I'm down. I'm down to watch it. Let me just drink some water. Oh god. That wasn't water, that was very cold tea. There you go, water. Sorry if me clearing my throat a lot. Like, I clear my throat a lot. There's always gunk in the back of my throat. I don't know why. But sorry if it hurts your ears having to listen to me clear my throat so much. So there's my room, and there's the store background that I use. They look real nice. I use it for a lot of the stuff that I promote. As you saw in my loading screen, I used it as part of the loading screen. I really like it. You okay there, Slime Joe? I am surviving somehow. Oh yeah, I'm still Slime Joe. Let me just... Hi, I'm back. Flip the page. These are the badges and emotes that I use. The badges were made by Ebizeb, which you may have seen earlier in chat. It was actually a birthday present. It was for my birthday in 2021. They offered to make these for me. And you can see them for those who are subbed. Starts off with a bronze coin leading up to platinum, and then the cash, the wallet, the bag of money. the channel points are those coupons, which is the bottom right. The glass jar, the tip jar, is part of the bits. I'm pretty sure it's the bits. I think I put it as the bits. You might see it there. The two little PNGs at the bottom are made by someone by Goody. Their account is currently locked, unfortunately, but I did still want to credit them, of course, because I want to credit everyone that helps me. What do you mean? Oh yeah, you are there. I thought you were saying, hey, I'm not on there, but yes, you are there. You're the emote on the very bottom right. The little angry emote. That was made by Honey. You could use that. Yeah, I think it's in the tier 1. Yeah, it's in the tier 1 sub emotes. Most of the emotes are made by me. Whether it's the ones that I drew myself. Also, Nino, welcome to the stream. Thanks for stopping by. I'm late, but welcome back. Thank you for having me back. It's very nice to see you again. The little emotes, like the first one, the light stick ones, that smug looking one next to the light sticks and the one with the gun, were drawn by me. All the noseless emotes were also made by me. I literally just made an expression, went onto the Clip Studio Paint, and took out the nose. That was it. And then shifted my face up a bit. Technically, the slime emotes were, drawn by the model artist PiaPI. I suppose she takes credit for those emotes as well. They are of the model. And Gomi as well, since they also help make that model, which also makes Sunny responsible for these emotes as well. Anyway, we have the little mascot over there on the in the middle, Connie the coin purse, which I drew one night. Just a cute little coin purse. She just sits there. She's also right there in the bottom, standing next to you guys on the stream avatars. Just chilling. Connie the coin purse. Ji-chan is just a just a small little grandpa that I made for some reason. But he hangs around every now and then. He's old, he's shaking. The model rigging looks so good. Oh yeah, it does, doesn't it? I love it. Okay. That's what's next? Did I do anything next? Ah, yes. Okay, so the tags that I use are Cujo Online, which I use for anything stream-related, whether it's the beginning or the end of a stream, or just announcements like that. Cujo Art is where I put all of my fan art, collab art, like art featuring me that's usually with someone else. Whatever doodles I make of my model, I also put on that that tag. Cujo Checkstand is the tag that I use for like all the general stuff, whether it's memes, all the shit posts that I do, the skits, clips, I usually put there as well with that checkstand. So if you go to my Twitter page, and I'll have links there as well. You'll be able to see that. Let me just... There you go. Okay. Cujo Vocals is the tag that I use for all of my song covers. You may see a lot of my song covers. that's where I put all of them. If you ever have the time and you want to hear how I sing, you'll find them there. Again, all of the covers that I make, usually up to the first chorus. Because, you know, Twitter doesn't allow for very long videos. So that's... they're usually just up to the first chorus. Fan name? I don't actually have a fan name. Well, I kind of did. When I started out, I started calling my followers customers. Which is about the, you know, what you would expect. I'm a grocery worker and they're called customers. But I wanted it... I was thinking of making something that was a bit more personal to me, but I couldn't think of anything. I tried, I couldn't think of anything. For all I know, y'all could be Cujo Copters. That's it. Yeah, you're Cujo Copters from now on. My Oshi mark is, which is pretty much just emojis that relate to me. It's just a beer and bento. This is my schedule. This is my projected schedule. I don't know how accurately I'm actually going to be following this, but I plan mostly to just do Sunday, Monday, Thursday, and Saturday. I'm actually thinking that maybe it's not so good for me to be like streaming concurrently. I wanted to try doing it every other day, but I don't know. Also, my schedule might change for the next couple months or so, because a couple of my coworkers are going on vacation. One of them is going on vacation for a couple months. The other one is going on vacation until the end of January. So, again, this is subject to change, but this is what I project my schedule is going to be. Here. These are my current goals. Right now, and you know, they're mixed long term and just goals for 2023. So right now I'm trying to get just 400 followers on Twitch by the end of 2023. I tried doing 300 by the end of 2022, but unfortunately I did not make that goal. Partly because I was not streaming by those last 3 months. Who knows, I could have made it. And then I want to do more karaoke streams. I'm trying to find a way to further soundproof my room so that when I do a karaoke stream, when I do a karaoke stream, it's not bothering everyone. I currently have a wall of soundproof foam on one of my walls, and then just before the stream I put a moving blanket, just like a thick blanket, over my door so that the sound doesn't leak through as much. It's hard to make that goal when you don't stream. Yes, that is true, that is true. Another thing that I want to do a I forgot that whenever I stream, for some reason, I tend to burp a lot. So, one of the things that I wanted to do is host a small Mario Kart tournament. I think it would be pretty fun to do a small Mario Kart tournament. Maybe I'll do a prize money of like $100, gather a bunch of people. Do a tournament. Whoever wins, wins. You ain't ready for that smoke. You can eat my... whatever. I'll beat you up, man. Like, don't... It's like, all the times that we played Mario Kart, I haven't practiced, man. If I practice, I'm a beat everyone, I swear. I swear I will. But one day I hope to do a Mario Kart tournament. It'd be pretty fun. It'd be pretty difficult to coordinate though. because that's gonna be... What's the maximum amount of people that can play Mario Kart? Is it 10? It's 12. No, it's 12, isn't it? Yeah, yeah. Maybe do like a best 2 out of 3? I don't know. I'll have to think about it. It's just a passing thought right now. But hopefully one day I can do a small tournament. Let's see. Read a light novel on stream. I have some light novels in my bookshelf. And I always wanted to just do a stream where I just read out to you. Yeah, it'll be like a story time. It'll be like a bedtime story. All I'll be doing is reading on stream. And it'll also help me with talking. Hopefully. I don't want to be reading a light novel and it's just going to be like, she said bag. And just like a bunch of stuttering and mixing up word slurring. But one day I'll do that. I want to do a fully produced music video. You know, kind of like the VTuber music videos that you see a lot. Like for all the like the Vocaloid songs. You know, there's always those VTuber music videos where it's like a static, kind of like a static image that changes up every now and then. It's usually like a glowing eyes, kind of like, you know, how everyone is everyone was covering, what was it called, King by Canaria. You know, the left side, right side, na 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 na. And everyone had a music video for that. I want to do one of those. You'll get 400 by next month, easy, with all the singing streams. If I do more singing streams. If I can get people interested in watching me sing live, because singing live is way more different for me than, you know, recording with my music software, where I can do multiple takes and make it sound good. I'm gonna be more flat singing live. Get legs. Get legs. That's it. That's my goal. Get legs. I want legs. I'm gonna be a full model one day. I'm gonna be a full model with legs. Let's see. What else? I have instruments. Again, you saw how many instruments I have. I want to be able to read music one day. I also have a bass guitar. I bought a bass guitar in 2020. And I think I've used it a total of 2 times. But I did buy a bass guitar. I think I actually posted a video of me playing it once. It was, I was playing a Filipino song called Beer. It's somewhere in my Twitter, I'll have to look for it later. But, again, I haven't used that thing in a while, and I'm not musically trained, so I can't use it well. But maybe one day, on stream, I will try to learn an instrument. Maybe it'll be the bass guitar, maybe it'll be the flute that I have, one of the 3 flutes that I have. Let's see here. Play games outside of my comfort zone. I play a lot of single players, of course. I want to play some like multiplayer games. Maybe I want to play Raft with some people. Minecraft, maybe. Play more horror games. I played one horror game last year. It was called Madison. It scared me a lot. It was fun though. It was fun, but I screamed a lot, so maybe I'll play more of those. And then, of course, I stated that I also wanted to play a lot more indie games, maybe story games, like story-driven indie games, like that. I'll have to look around, and if anyone wants to recommend me any game, I'll take a look at that as well. Again, I want to have fun. Some of these goals I also lifted from my initial debut. Have fun was one of those. that last one I literally added right before stream because I remember it was a goal that I wanted to have that I said like passively at some point. Passively is not the right word, but I said it in passing. I just want to be able at some point tweet the word beef and then it just gets a whole bunch of likes for no reason. It's like that's how I know I will have made it, is if I tweet beef and then it goes into trending. Those are my goals. Those are my current goals. I think this is actually the end of my presentation. Yeah, I don't have anything else after this. Yeah, it's done now. It's done now. Wow, look at that. You have reached the end of my redebut PowerPoint slide. Would you look at that? I actually don't know. I didn't plan for anything afterwards. Oh, I guess this is the point where I have to serenade you, don't I? This is the part where I sing you a song. I remember I sang a song last time. Hopefully, I didn't practice anything though, so hopefully. Bald? Okay, yeah. I'll do bald. I will. What's a good song for me to sing? Here, let me go into this. Give me 1 second. Okay. I will sing you one or two songs. I have to think about it for a moment. It'll have to be something that's easy on my vocal cords right now, considering I haven't practiced anything. I know. It's a song that I sang a couple times already on karaoke streams, but it's easy enough for me that I can just sing it without practice. Let me turn off my BGM. Turn on my reverb. And then I'm also going to do something real quick. Give me 1 second. Testing. Okay. So what I did just now is that I unhooked my mic from my mic stand, so I am now physically holding my mic. Because for some reason I feel like I sing better if I'm holding the mic. Also because I tend to move a lot. I tend to move a lot while I sing. And I'm actually also standing up. So my desk, it can raise up into a standing desk. And I just rose it a bit. Hopefully, okay, good. Tracking's still good. And now I'm holding a mic because I also move a lot when I sing. Because I feel like I sing better when I move. Let me go ahead and start the music. Hopefully the music isn't too loud either. Give me 1 second. Tell me if the music is loud though. Warm-up song. L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can love. Is all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made for me and you. Is the volume of the song okay? Not too loud, is it? Hopefully not. It's good? Okay, good.
L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore can love. Is all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can make it. Take my heart and please don't break it. Love was made for me and you. Love was made for me and you. Love was made for me and you.
There you go. That was one song. That was one song. It's perfect. It's perfect. Is there another song that I could sing for you guys? Is this going to be an impromptu karaoke stream? There you go. I'm hitting my goal. Let's go with something softer. Let's see if I can... A little softer song. This part is definitely going to be DMCA'd, but that's okay. It's fine. I have a copy of it. It'll live forever. Oh no. Okay.
Track suits and red wine. Movies for two. We'll take off our phones and we'll turn off our shoes. We'll play Nintendo, though I always lose. 'Cause you watch the TV while I'm watching you. There's not many people I'd honestly say I don't mind losing to. But there's nothing like doing nothing with you. Dumb conversations, you lose track of time. Have I told you lately I'm grateful you're mine? We'll watch The Notebook for the 17th time. I'll say it's stupid and you'll catch me crying. We're not making out on a boat in the rain or in a house I painted blue. But there's nothing like doing nothing with you.
Oh, you love this song, do you? Oh, big shoes to fill.
So shut all the windows and lock all the doors. When I'm looking for no one, don't need nothing more. You'll buy my lip and I want you more. Until we end up in a heap on the floor.
I thought we were gonna sing YMCA. That's not a soft song at all.
We could be dancing on tabletops, wearing high heels, drinking until the world spins like a wheel. But tonight your apartment has so much appeal. Who needs stars? We've got a roof. But there's nothing like doing nothing with you. There's nothing like doing nothing with you.
And that was Nothing by Bruno Major. A little song that I discovered, I think it was last year. But I really liked it, so I think I actually have a cover of that song on Twitter as well. I want to say. Again, Cujo Vocals. You saw the tags. If you want to see it, it's right there. A little bit of self-promotion. You want to hear me sing YMC? I can't. I can't. Other than not knowing the lyrics, it's also too loud for me to do right now. Let's see. Another song. Another... Oh, wait. Oh, can I do that? Wait. If you're not a fan of country, I'm sorry. Although, this is probably a country song that you might know. Wait, my voice can't even go that low. My voice can't go this low. Baby, lock them door and turn the lights down low. Put some music on it soft and slow. Baby, we ain't got no place to go. I hope you understand. I've been thinking about this all day long. Never felt a feeling quite this strong. I can't believe how much it turns me on just to be your man. There's no hurry, don't you worry. We can take our time. Come a little closer, let's go over what I had in mind. Maybe lock them door and turn the lights down low. And put some music on that soft and slow. Baby, we ain't got no place to go. I hope you understand. I've been thinking about this all day long. Never felt a feeling quite this strong. I can't believe how much it turns me on just to be your man. I think I always wanted to sing this song on a karaoke stream, but now I finally get to do it, so that's good. Ain't nobody ever loved nobody the way that I love you. We're alone now, you don't know how long I wanted to. Lock them door and turn the lights down low. And put some music on it soft and slow. And baby, we ain't got no place to go. I hope you understand. I've been thinking about this all day long. Never felt a feeling that was quite this strong. I can't believe how much it turns me on just to be your man. I can't believe how much it turns me on just to be your man. How's that? You like that? Was that good? I don't think I perfectly hit those lower notes, but that's fine. I'm sorry, it was good. Thank you. Do I even know any more songs that I can, because I gotta think of songs that I can just hit lower notes. I can't do big ones right now. Luther Vandross Dance with My Father. I unfortunately do not know that song. The only Luther Vandross song I know is what's it called? Let me hold you tight, if only for one night. Let me keep you near to ease away your fears. It'll be so nice, if only for one night. And then that's all I know of that song. What was that song's name again? It's called Let Me Hold You or something. No, it's If Only for One Night. Let Me Hold You is the song that sampled that song by... Oh, I forgot his name. Okay. Let's see. I'm looking through my playlist, see if there's anything good. No. I'll probably do one more song. One more song somewhere. Can't Help Falling in Love? Okay, yeah, that I can do that one, yeah. Elvis. Classic. Oh, hey, EGP, welcome.
Welcome. Sale today.
Thanks for stopping by. You almost missed the Joe Joshua re-debut. Unfortunately, you are at the end, but technically, yes, you did make it. Thank you for stopping by.
Wise men say only fools rush in, but
time.
Jinx, thank you for the resub. Thank you very much for your support. It looks like we have a high chain closing in. Okay. I do believe that might be the end of the stream. What do you think? What do you think? I sang more songs than I plan to. Let's get him to a high train. If you are able to do that, that would be very, very awesome. But it's okay if it doesn't. Maybe in the meantime, I'll look for another song. Let's see. What if I could do this one? Oh, whoa, EGB.
We're having a sale.
Thank you for the five subs, five gifted subs. Thank you, thank you. Hey, yo, let's go. Look at that. Absolute mad lad. Love of my life, you've hurt me. You've broken my heart, and now you leave me. Love of my life, can you see? Bring it back. Don't take it away from me, because you don't know what it means to me.
One more person, huh? For the hype train. Someone bring out the credit card. Oh, James, thank you for the gifted sub. Oh, I think it has to be a different person, though.
Back, hurry back. Please bring him back home to me, because you don't know what it means to me. Love of my life. Love of my life.
Got it. Wait, it's already at level 3? How did that... Wait, what? How did that happen? Wait, didn't it just start? It's saying level 3 on my end. No way. But thank you, thank you. Thank you, honey, for the 100 bits. Thank you, thank you. Is that... I guess that means I should keep going, huh? Should I keep going? Okay, sinking. I'm just clicking onto whatever music, karaoke is next. Oh, I have time. I'm not doing anything after this anyway. Highway run into the midnight sun. Wheels go round and round, you're on my mind.
What happened? Someone just changed my voice. Oh no, I can't hear what it says. I can't see what it says. Oh, you used Chipmunk, didn't you? I think I saw Chipmunk. Oh, along the wire.
They say that the road ain't no place to start a family. Right down the line, it's been you and me. And love in the music, man, ain't always what it's supposed to be. Oh, girl, you stand by me. I'm forever yours, faithfully. Favorite bands, by the way, first is Queen, second is Journey. Circus life under the big top world. We all need the clowns to make us smile. Through space and time, always another show. Wondering where I am, lost without you. Being apart ain't easy on this love affair. Oh, I forgot how this line goes. Again, I get the joy of rediscovering you. Oh, girl, you stand by me. I'm forever yours, faithfully. Okay, after this is this part, after that part is just a bunch of instrumental and a lot of saying whoa. So I'm gonna skip all that. Let's see. Okay, what else is good, huh? What else is good? Something low. Something easy. Something... let's see here. I think I also sang this for my last, EGP, thank you for the 5 gifted subs. Let's fucking go! Thank you. Let's see, Green grass of home. I know a lot of... The thing about the songs that I sing is that I sing a lot of ballads, rock ballads, love ballads. I think it's the best genre for my voice because of how slow some of them are. I'm better with slow songs. Oh, thank you for the shout out, honey. Man's playing Gundam Evolution. I tried that game once. I'm horrible at it. But it looked fun. It looks fun.
The old hometown looks the same as I step down from the train. And there to meet me is my mama and papa. Down the road and there runs Mary, hair of gold and lips like cherries. It's good to touch the green, green grass of home. Yes, they'll all come to see me. Arms reaching, smiling sweetly. It's good to touch the green, green grass of home. The old house is still standing, though the paint is cracked and dry. And there's that old oak tree that I used to play on. Down the lane I walk with my sweet Mary, hair of gold and lips like cherries. It's good to touch the green, green grass of home.
This is the part that's just talking. And then I wake and look around me at four gray walls that surround me. And I realize, yes, I was only dreaming. For there's a God, and there's a sad old padre.
As always,
arm in arm, we'll walk at daybreak. Again, I'll touch the green, green grass of home. Mike Yanks, thank you for the follow. Welcome to the stream.
Yes, they'll all come to see me in the shade of that old oak tree as they lay me beneath the green, green grass of home.
Da-dant. EGP, I think I saw you suggest Daft Punk. I don't know if I know any Daft Punk songs. I think I know one. It's let's see if I know how to sing it. I think it's probably the Daft Punk song that Oh, I had the Daft Punk voice filter. Oh, okay, I thought you were asking me to sing Daft Punk. Okay. I guess I won't then. Someone fill all the lyrics for that on a Rubik's Cube? What? Oh, harder, better, faster, stronger. Okay, okay, okay. Let's see. What song? What song? Song, 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 song. Song, 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 song. Oh no, that's just the same one. Here, you could hear it? Okay, let me look at this real quick. Open.
Meet me, it's my mama and papa.
Oh, okay, I hear it.
Down the road.
That didn't sound that nice. Oh, let's see here. Oh man, level 4 hype train. Thank you very so much. What did I just say? Thank you very so much. Thank you very much. Just forget I said that. I gotta think of another song. Gotta think of another song. Think of another song. What other songs do I know, actually? It's one of those things where you think of, someone asks you, you know, like, oh, what kind of songs do you like? Or oh, what kind of games or books or movies do you like? And then you forget everything you ever knew. It's like, oh, shoot, what do I know? What do I like? So if I were to look up a song, let me just check my stuff. Actually, let me try this one. Until I don't know how well I'll be able to sing this live, especially since I'm gonna have to do it very low, like an octave down. So let me see. Let me look for a piano one. piano.
Georgia, wrap me up in all your, I want ya. In my arms, oh let me hold ya. I'll never let you go again like I did. Oh, I used to say I would never fall in love again until I found her. I said I would never fall unless it's you I've fallen to. I was lost within the darkness, but then I found her. I found. Georgia pulled me in, I asked to love her. Once again you fell, I caught ya. I'll never let you go again like I did. Oh, I used to say I would never fall in love again until I found her. I said I would never fall unless it's you I've fallen to. I was lost within the darkness, but then I found her. I found. Until I found her, I said I would never fall unless it's you I've fallen to. I was lost within the darkness, but then I found her. I found you.
Can you sing Lonely Day by System of a Down? Oh man, unfortunately I don't know that song. Let me see if I know a song by System of a Down that I do know though. If I remember correctly. See if I remember how to sing the song.
What is a waterfall? One in a river and one again after the fall. Swimming through the void, we hear the words and lose ourselves, but we find it all.
I can't belt right now. I can't go that high right now.
Cause we are the ones who wanna play. Always wanna go, but they never wanna stay.
Oh, whoops. I messed that one up.
And we are the ones who wanna choose. Always wanna play, but you never wanna lose.
I was not prepared for this song.
Aerials in the sky. When you lose small mind, you free your lies. Life is a waterfall. You drink from the river, then you turn around and put up a walls.
I keep almost going an octave down.
Swimming through the void, we hear the word. We lose ourselves, but we find it all.
Cause we are the ones who wanna play. Always wanna go, but they never wanna stay. And we are the ones who wanna choose. Always wanna play, but you never wanna lose. Oh.
I do a scream there, but not this time.
Aerials in the sky, where you lose small mind, you free your life. Aerials so up high, where you free your eyes, eternal prize. Aerials in the sky, when you lose small mind, you free your life. Aerials so up high, when you free your eyes, eternal prize.
Was that okay, honey? Did that work? Did that work for you? I know I said that I wasn't going to be loud, but unfortunately that is a loud song. It's okay, I can do at least one, right? We were doing rock. Someone suggested System of a Down, and I kind of only know how to sing one song well, decently. System of a Down. Let's see. Ooh, I know. Since we're along this genre, I like how I said I'd only be playing, singing a couple songs, but here I am singing a lot of songs now. It's okay. I got swept up in it, right? Hopefully you're finding this entertaining. Look at that, I already crossed out one part of my 2023 resolution, which was to do another karaoke stream. Okay, let's hope I know how to sing this one. It's Red Hot Chili Peppers, by the way.
Lipstick junkie debunked the only one. She came back wearing a smile, looking like someone drugged me. They wanted to unplug me. No one here is on trial. It's just a turn around and we go. Oh, well then we go. Oh, oh, oh. Tick tock, I want to rock. You like the 80s, cock blocking isn't allowed. Tugboat Sheila is into memorabilia. Who said three is a crowd? We better get it on the go. Hey now, we've gotta make it rain somehow. She told me to show me what to do. A Maggie makes it in a cloud. I said, hey now, we gotta make it rain somehow. She told me to and show me what to do. She knows how to make it loud, loud.
I almost forgot the lyrics there.
Rain dance, Maggie advances to the final. Who knew that she had the goods. Little did I know her body was one delicious vinyl to your neck of the woods. I want to lick it a little bit. Hey now, we've got to make it rain somehow. She told me to and showed me what to do. A Maggie makes it in a cloud. I said, hey.
Oh, whoops.
You got the wrong girl, but not for long, girl. It's in the song, girl, 'cause I'll be gone, girl. Hey now, we've got to make it rain somehow. She told me to and showed me what to do. A Maggie makes it in a cloud. I said, hey now, I want to rock this radic crowd.
Whoops, cloud.
She told me to and showed me what to do. She knows how to make it loud, But not for long, girl. It's in the song, girl. 'Cause I'll be gone. Bye bye, yeah. Bye bye bye, girl. And I'm ding dong. Bait on a bait on bomb, but a bit of a bomb, bomb, but a bomb, bomb. Girl, bye bye.
Long intro. That's pretty much that's pretty much the end of that song.
Don't.
All right. I don't know if there's any other songs you want me to sing. Don't what? Yo, Jojo, long time no see. Hey, what's up, Rixto? Welcome to the stream. Thank you for stopping by. You've caught us on our the karaoke section of the unexpected karaoke section of my re-debut. You said don't? Don't? I said don't? Don't? Oh, I said don't? You have a nice singing voice. Thank you very much. I like to think that I'm decent enough at singing. I sing a lot in my car. Mostly in my car. I'm on my way to work. I'm usually singing something. Especially on the ride back when it's darker and no one can see me. I'm struggling to do high notes. Don't? More like Duma. What's Duma? Doom on these... Okay, never mind. I'm not going to say it. Car singing is a tech for sure. It's how you learn. It's how you learn. Okay, I think... I know... Oh, man. I'm going to try singing a... Japanese song. Oh, hopefully I know how to do this. Duma ball spin. There it is. Here's another one. Better one than that, huh? There you go. Okay, here it goes. Hopefully I can do this. I think I only know, like, the first half of the song, though.
Yonaka ni ikinari sa いつ空いてるのデラインん君とはもう3年くらい会ってないのにどうしたのあの頃僕たちはさ何でもできる気がしてた二人で海に行ってはたくさん写真撮ったねでも見てよ今の僕をクズになった僕を人を傷つけてまた泣かせても何も感じ取れなくてさ別に君を求めてないけど横にいられると思い出す君のドルチェ&ガバナのその香水のせいだよさら君に会ったさ僕は何を言ったらいい可愛くなったね口先でしか言えないよどうしたのいきなりさあタバコなんかくわえ出して悲しくないよ悲しくないよ君が変わっただけだからでも見てよ今の僕を空っぽの僕を人に嘘ついて軽蔑されて涙一つも出なくてさ別に君を求めてないけど横にいられると思い出す君のドルチェ&ガバナのその香水のせいだよ普通に君をまた好きになることなんてありえないけど君のドルチェ&ガバナの香水が思い出させる
I'm struggling Okay, I forget this part.
どう思う? 別に君を求めてないけど横にいられると思い出す君のドルチェ&ガバナのその香水のせいだよ別に君をまた好きになるくらい君は素敵な人だよでもまた同じことの繰り返しで僕が振られるんだ
ドゥルルルドゥンドゥンドゥンドゥンドゥルルルドゥンドゥンドゥルルルドゥンドゥンドゥンドゥンドゥルルルドゥンドゥン
Ah man. Ah man.I think I may have shot my voice with that one. I can't wait to go back to that and listen to how I absolutely flubbed it. But I think my voice is actually shot. I made a mistake, guys.Thank you. I will drink some water. Oh no. All right. I think that might actually be.The end of this stream. Thank you everyone who stopped by today.
It was very fun time. I'm glad to be back. I don't know if I'll be able to do this. I'm gonna try to do the Monday stream. I was actually thinking of like officially starting up stream like on like next Saturday, but I'll try to see if I can do tomorrow, because I don't want to. It's like I've been working pretty hard lately at work, and I kind of wanted just like a day off after today, because I've been like you know, like I've been preparing for this, and I just wanted a day off for Monday, especially after the holidays and all that, because I work both holidays. So you might see me. I'm gonna try maybe earliest Tuesday or Thursday. Actually, I don't know if I'm gonna do Tuesday. Maybe Thursday. I don't know what game I'll play, but I might try to do a stream on Thursday. So again, thank you very much for sticking around. I'm sorry that my voice is a bit hoarse at the moment. I think it might be breaking up a bit. Thank you for the hype train. It means a lot to me that y'all came around. So let me see if there's anyone for me to raid tonight. I gotta keep my voice down now. I'm pretty sure I may have disturbed someone doing all that singing. Okay, let's see. I don't think I've raided Spectre in a while. Spectre HD. Let's see here. Okay, good. They're still going. I didn't want to accidentally stream at the end of their stream. So let me go ahead and put that in there. Oh no, how do I do this again? It's been a while. Bear with me. No? Oh no, it's like dash SO, isn't it? No, not shout out. It's raid. What am I doing? I did the command for shouting out when I meant to do a raid. Okay. So there's that. Oh no, Nightbot doesn't have the raid message. When's the last time? Okay, there's Nightbot. I'm gonna gift a sub to Nightbot real quick. Hopefully that goes through. Okay, good.
Attention shoppers, we're having a sale today.
So raid. Raid sub. Those are going to be the raid messages for tonight. Again, thank you very much for stopping by, and I will see you another time. So have a good night, okay?